What's going on, you guys? My name is Zach Hartley, and welcome to another weekly watchlist video. In this one, I am going to show you my current holdings, as well as the stocks that are at the top of my watchlist going into Monday morning. Here is everything you need to know. Let's go. Okay, so first of all, my small account challenge. We started this back in August with 1,070, and today on Friday at the close, we hit a record high of 5,500. You can remember I finished the year at 4,800, so we've already made 700 bucks in just a little over 2 weeks, so we're doing extremely well. I did pick up a couple new positions this week in the crypto space, and we'll see how that works out for me. All of them are down right now. You can see I picked up Mara, Hive, and Routemaster here. None of them are doing extremely well yet, but I do have stop losses on all of those positions, as well as all of my psychedelic positions. However, they're doing extremely well. Mine met up over 500% right now, but the trade I want to talk about this week was Egg Eagle. So this was UAVs. I saw this stock run up here, and I missed the run up, but I did buy in on the dip, and I actually bought in at the perfect time right here. This was the lowest it came, and then it ran back up. So far, I'm up 66% in just 9 days of trading. I bought the dip and it continues to run higher. I am super, super happy with this one, and I am in at $6.03. So we're doing really, really well. Now, this week, we had a phenomenal week when you look at all of the indices. The S&P 500, the NASDAQ, and the Dow Jones all set all-time highs. Thursday and Friday were not great days for them, but we did set new highs this week. So in my book, it was a good week and the markets are looking strong right now. As you can see, the S&P 500 is kind of riding this trend line right now, and it has not crossed below that trend line. So I'm feeling really good about the markets right now and all of the indexes in general. Now, when we look at COVID, it was a better week than it was last week. So that's a good thing. When we look at COVID, daily new cases in the United States, that's the chart that I'm looking at, pulled from worldometer.com. The numbers went down this week compared to the week before. So that's definitely a good sign. However, we're definitely still clearly in the middle of a third wave. Hopefully it doesn't get to a fourth wave, because it's looking pretty bad, especially in specific states. Now, Drone Delivery Canada, I tried to tell you guys about this company. I tried to tell you that there was support at 80 cents. I'm gonna run the clip right now. However, I do think there's a little bit of support at 80 cents, and if we start to see a bounce through this trend line and a little bit of a clear bounce off of 80 cents, I think there's some value in Drone Delivery Canada. And I personally think drones are gonna be massive in 2021 and 2022. I think all of the drone companies are gonna do extremely well. Now, that video was posted 2 watchlist videos ago, and this is what the chart looked like back then. And then last week, I showed it again, and this is what the chart looked like, and I said that there's still value. I still think it's a good buy here. And this week, this is what the chart looks like. We are now at $1.16 as a high. We closed out at $1.08, and the stock ran from 80 cents where I said there was support, closed out the week at $1.08. In a matter of 2 weeks, the stock is up over 25-30%. Absolutely phenomenal. I'm in at an average price of 65 cents. And hold up, I just want to show you this chart one more time. Boom, boom. Called it the entire way through. So I just want to point that out, because I'm feeling pretty good about that stock pick right now. Now, Dragonfly is another stock that I've done extremely well on. I bought in on the way up right here. I'm in at 82 cents. It's now at $1.84 in, again, a matter of less than 10 days worth of trading. Doing extremely well on it. I still think there's value here, even though it has run up so much. I think all three of these companies are going to do extremely well long term. Now, Facebook is the first stock that I want to talk about where I think there's a real opportunity here. The reason I think there's an opportunity here is because this basically 245 level acted as resistance in July. The stock gapped up above 245, kind of retested it again right here, ran to 304, came all the way back down to 245, tested it again, ran all the way back up to like 295 before coming back down to this 245 level again. We tested it on Thursday. We had a nice green day on Friday. I think there's some support here at 245. And so if we see Facebook continue to trade sideways or bounce off of 245, I think there's an excellent, very easy trade here. And let me break it down for you. Current price is $251. You get into the stock right at 251. You put a stop loss at $238, just below the 240 level. So you got some room to play here, and you got some room to play here as well. So 238 is where I would get out. That is where the trade is wrong and the stock is going to keep falling. 238, I'm out, but I would start to take profit at $277, or I would convert my trade into a trailing stop loss. And that way I have a very easy 1-to-2 risk to return ratio. And I think the stock has a ton of room to run higher than 277. So I think there's a really, really easy trade with Facebook. This is not a signal. Do your own due diligence. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm not responsible for your trading. But if you want to learn how to trade, I do have a course for that. It is called my Stock Market Fundamentals course. And you get 2 weeks completely free when you sign up on Skillshare. After that, it's about $20 per month, but it's a 9-hour course. And if you can do the entire 9 hours in under under 2 weeks. You got the entire thing for free. There's over 80 or 90 reviews now. There's 1,400 students that have gone through the course, and there's a link down below. I promise you it will be the best free online resource that you can find. Now, the next stock that I'm really interested in is Beyond Meat. The reason I'm interested in Beyond Meat is because I made a lot of money on Beyond Meat swing trading it, and I'm really happy with the stock because it has very clear levels of support and resistance. So a very clear level of support right here around this 110, 115 level. Stock bounced off 115, ran all the way up to 140. Previous resistance right here, really easy to see that it was gonna run out there. Now we are looking for it to either come back down to 110 and buy back in again, or break through 140 and run back up to the kind of like 190, 200 range. It's gonna do one of those two things, and whichever way it goes, you do have a trading opportunity there. The nice thing is, when you have very clear levels of support and resistance, it makes inserting your stop loss very easy because you know exactly at what point your trade is wrong, and that's when you wanna get out. So that's how I think about this one. I think there's a big opportunity with Beyond Meat. I also think there's a big opportunity with Field Trip. Now these guys are in the psychedelic space. You can see here they gapped up to a high of around $3.50. They ran up to $7, they came down from $7 and came right down to $3.50 again. Green day on Thursday, gap up on Friday, doing really, really well. I think there's a great opportunity here in Field Trip. They also advertise like crazy. I can't tell you how many ads I get for this company. It's absolutely unbelievable, but they have support right here at $3.50. You can look at the volume. It's steadily increasing over the last 3 days. And the MACD looks like it's about to cross over. So some really good signs here for Field Trip. I think there's a great opportunity. Now, if you are interested in seeing any more of my charts and my technical analysis, then you should definitely consider signing up for my Discord chat. That is where I'm trying to build a community of traders that share their resources, share their trade ideas, and try and build everybody up. I post all of my technical analysis, all of my watch lists every single week. And it's basically a community where it's somewhere that you don't have to sit at home alone and stare at your computer, somewhere you can bounce your ideas off the wall. So if you're interested in that, it is $5 per month. I'd love to have you there, and there's a link down in the description below to sign up. Now, in summary, these are the industries I am in, these are the industries I'm interested in, and these are the industries where I think there's an opportunity. Number one is drones, number two is graphene, number three is psychedelics, number four is tech, and I took three different positions in crypto. It's under 10% of my portfolio, so I did not put big money into it. However, all of them are down right now, so I'm not so sure about crypto. I got a little bit of money in it. All of them have stop losses, so I'm not worried about it at all. If I get out, I lose like 3%. I'm not too concerned about it, but there's a big opportunity there. I know long-term, I do think it's gonna be big. So that is my opinion for this week ahead. If you guys got any value out of this video, please consider hitting that like and subscribe button. I sincerely appreciate it. My only goal here is to help you make more money. So good luck trading, good luck investing. See you tomorrow.